Welcome to the Richaado Show.
Why, hello there! My name is Richard, and indeed, welcome to the Richaado Show. And now, hands up, who likes their football?
Ow! Ow! Not that kind of football. I'm talking about the other sort.
Ow! Not even that sort of football. I'm talking about bloody association football here, guys. Or as you American audiences would call soccer. Whatever floats your boat, I guess.
For a game that was first played all the way back in the 1860s, it has certainly come a long way, and I think I'm right in saying that it's probably the most popular competitive team sport
in the world.
There aren't many nations on planet Earth today that don't have their own football league or national representative team, but there are some leagues that are definitely more popular than others. The English Premier League, La Liga, Serie A, the Bundesliga, Major League Soccer, and countless others too numerous to mention.
So naturally, when video games came in, there had to be some football games in development sooner or later. And I know there are a lot of different football game series out there, but I'm going to talk about the most prevalent and arguably the most popular out there. The FIFA series.
And so this series began when the first FIFA football game, FIFA International Soccer, came out in 1993. Virtually every year following, there has been a new game released. The FIFA series is now somewhat of a fan favourite in my country, but for me it's grown into something that I just can't get into. I mean, it could be that I just don't play many sports simulation games, but I just think that the culture surrounding these games today has become too confusing for me to get into, and I'm still resentful of Electronic Arts at the moment.
Go die in a hole!
Luckily for me, however, I managed to keep hold of one specific FIFA game from a time when EA were as nearly as hated or loved as they are today. And specifically, it's... I'll give you a couple of seconds to have an educated guess. Nope, you're quite wrong. It's FIFA 99. Unless you actually said it was FIFA 99, in which case you were right and I was wrong to say that you were wrong and blag.
Release date, June 1998. Available on Windows, PlayStation 1 and Nintendo 64. And that's it. I wish I could say more about this game, but it's one of the few FIFA games that doesn't have its own Wikipedia article. I can, however, say that this title improved on the previous games in the series with better graphics, basic facial animations, as well as the option to create your own custom competitions. It supposedly performed well in terms of sales, managing to usurp Tomb Raider 3 as the best-selling game in the UK charts a few months after its release.
So how will this all fare when we actually get into the game? Well... Hang on. Can't carry on yet. I can't continue. Something missing, but I don't know what it is. Hang on a second. That's it. Turns out I'm wearing the wrong shirt. For me, if you're in the wrong shirt, it's basically like doing this review naked. I mean, you may as well do everything the right way, so give us a moment. Ha! Yes! This is the shirt I wanted. I'm virtually ready now. And as a measure of how thorough I'm being here, I've even got the shirt name and the jersey number. So yeah, doing this thoroughly. Even though I look like a little bit of a perk. Literally, no expense spared here. So, now that I'm ready, our journey to find out whether FIFA 99 is treasure or trash can now finally begin. So, and we have kickoff.
You see what I did there, with the kicker for the football jokes and stuff.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
You know what, for all the flack that EA are receiving right now, I will always like that one jingle.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
And this next montage really intrigues me. I didn't realise that motion capture technology was being utilised as far back as 1998, so this should make for some fun times when I get to the actual game. In theory. And then we have this unusually epic opening FMV. It feels almost exactly like an inspirational Rocky training montage, and it looks like it's building up to something truly special. In theory. Hang on a second, is that the Rockefeller skank playing in the background? Yes, my friends, it is. And this game continues the trend of using licensed soundtracks that started with the previous FIFA game, Rota World Cup 98. And if you ask me, the tracks used back then are certainly a lot better than some of the tracks used in some of the more recent games. I mean, seriously, what is with the freaking horse noise? Ah, main menu time. And do you see the neat football theming here with the icons being in pentagon shapes like a football has? Yeah, minor details. The one thing that I have to criticize about the menus is the actual navigation. Using the arrow keys to cycle through items is fine, of course, but if you want to select items, you need to press the start button. And to move back through menus, it's the select button. Now, I don't know about you, but a lot of menus I've been through made me use the X and triangle buttons to navigate. And if I'm honest, I'd have been happier if it did it like that. It's completely baffling. Why would you use the freaking start and select buttons to go back and forth through the menus? And now excuse me while I slowly disappear. Now let's jump into a friendly match and pick our teams. And I know just who to pick. So it's an English team and... Where is it? It'll be here. Trust me, it'll be here. I know it. I know it'll be here. They're not here. They're not here. My beloved Bradford City aren't here.
What's up with that? Didn't they realise that lower teams still exist in lower divisions?
Well, okay, I'll lay off a little bit. Because maybe trying to put in more teams from lower divisions wasn't viable until they eventually did it in FIFA 2004. So seeing as I don't like any of these English teams, let's pick...
Dieser Fußballmannschaft!
Y esta equipo de fútbol. And let's go, go, go! Yeah, I've got no idea who any of these players are. Oh, hey, this seems simple enough. Whoa, hang on. Oh, wait a second. What the f*** am I being booked for? What did I do? I quit. I'm done. I'm finished. Oh, go on. Elba scores. Oh.
You don't know what you're doing.
Oh, look at that. He's up like a salmon. Yes! What do you know about epic goal-scoring prowess? With only 10 men on the pitch as well. Electronic Arts, computer programmers, artificial intelligence, your boys just took one hell of a beating.
So I guess that was a good time spent there. But I have to apologise for the blatant lack of analytical comments made in those last few minutes. So let's just slow everything down and take a deeper, proper look at this game.
So aside from the quick game and friendly modes, the other main game modes are Season Mode, Golden Goal Mode, in which the first to reach a set number of goals wins, Dream League Mode, consisting of the best teams in the world at that time, and the Training Mode, where you can practice set pieces and hold practice matches. There is also a team and player modification tool where you can change play starts and appearances if you're so inclined. Personally, I'm not, so that's that covered. Moving on! Season Mode sounds like a substantial game mode, but first, let's get some practice on our belts. So we can practice corners, free kicks, and penalties. Well, penalties seem simple enough. Pick a direction and shoot the ball into the net.
Screw you guys, I'm getting hit.
Ah, now I feel ready for whatever lays ahead. So let's go into the season mode. And it looks like I can play a league or a cup tournament. Well, a cup tournament sounds like less effort. Let's go with that. So I've decided to conduct my review whilst aiming for glory in the Champions League with Real Madrid. Well, firstly, the competition structure is faithful to the real thing, starting with a group stage before the knockout games. Good max there, I guess. So the first game is coming up and I'm feeling pumped.
Let me at 'em.
So the very basic controls are as follows. The direction pad or analog stick will move whichever player you're controlling in 8 directions. You can make them run faster by repeatedly tapping the triangle button while moving, but this tires out players faster. When in possession of the ball, you can perform various passing moves to your teammates with the X button or the R1 button for a through ball. You can lob the ball downfield with the square button, and once you're in range of the opposition's goal, you can attempt a shot with the circle button. When defending or trying to get the ball back, you can change which player you're controlling with the X button, you can use the square button to perform a slide tackle to try and dislodge the ball from your opponent's feet. And really, that's all you need to know if you want to play the game. I suppose this adds a bit to the pick-up and playability of this game, so even the most casual newcomer can pick up the controller and join in the action. But there is a whole lot more to your movesets than just that. If you look in the manual, there's a good few pages explaining all the commands and tricks you can pull off and... Oh. Oh my god. There's so many of them. How do you expect to know all of this off by heart? Help me. Somebody! And like in the real game, there are rules you need to follow. Failing to do so may result in a foul being given against you or the offending player being booked with a yellow or red card. You might get pinged for being offside past the last defender or coming in with an unacceptable challenge for the ball. And if you know how the real rules of the game work in the real world, I think you'll agree that the refereeing system in this game is pretty accurate to the real thing. And by that I mean...
It's completely nonsensical!
The fouls seem to be given out really randomly, and what seems like a legal tackle to you is apparently not so in the game. Like I said, just like the real thing!
Speaking of realism, let's take a moment to look at the graphics and sound effects. You know, overall I have to say that the designers have done a really commendable job on the game's visuals for its time. They've managed to create replicas of real world stadiums and the players' jerseys look more realistic with various folds and creases in the textures. Every kit is not exactly a full replica of what the team had at the time, but in the grand scheme of things, it's pretty understandable that minor details had to be left out. There are a couple of bouts of glitchiness in some of the textures, such as in the crowds, but they're just small nitpicks, and overall this game looks pretty good for its day. As for the sound effects, they're very true and realistic to what you might expect in the real world. I wouldn't be surprised if those recordings were of actual football fans at a real match. Plus, you have the wonderful voice of the legendary John Motson providing commentary as you play, assisted by Mark Lawrenson and Chris Waddle.
I'm so sorry if you have no idea who these people are.
This commentating feature, however, falls into the trap of overusing certain phrases, making it all become stale pretty quickly. The lack of variety in commentary might have been down to technical limitations, but still, a few more different phrases would have been nice. So during the halftime break, or when you pause the game, you have the option to manage your team, substitute new players to replace others, and watch an instant replay of the last few minutes of action. But have you seen how fast the scrolling is in these menus?
Scrolling around at the speed of sound.
In fact, this leads me nicely onto another point I'd like to make about the pacing of the game. What I mean by that is this. The flow of the game feels a bit too fast. The camera has a hard time struggling to follow the ball as it gets flung every which way around the pitch. Combined with the limited field of view, it gets difficult to manage where everything is, and it isn't helped anymore by the fact that the computer players take their corners, goal kicks and throw-ins almost instantaneously when the ball goes out of play. Some longer pauses in play would have helped to break up the pace a little bit, but I still concede that it doesn't take too much away from some pretty solid gameplay overall.
And to be honest, a lot of the flaws in this game can make for some really laugh out loud moments, and if you're with some friends in a multiplayer situation, it makes for a very fun night of gaming. I mean, this is a PlayStation 1 game that can support up to 8 players if you have 2 multi-tap peripherals. So there's plenty of reason for you to go out and grab a copy and get some mates together and have some fun with it.
Aside from that, we have a tournament to win, and after 3 matches, I'm in the hunt. But I'm also incredibly bored. That's the thing, if you decide to go on a single player tournament experience, you need to be prepared to play a lot of games to get through it all. And you may need multiple sittings to be able to get through a competition. Luckily for you, FIFA 99 gives you the chance to save your progress and return later, or you can choose to simulate your next game. As far as I'm aware, this option just generates a random scoreline for your next game so you can progress through the tournament quickly. Fingers crossed and... Oh, look at that, it's a draw. But then it's a win! And another! And now I've reached the knockout phase. And now, let us gallantly go forth and hope victory swings in our favour. And boom, there we go. I've made it to the final against the dreaded United. Oh hey, finally there's some players I recognise. Peter Schmeichel, Ryan Giggs, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, and Becks himself. The time has come, and we shall not go quietly. Now, I have to say, it's really easy to lose yourself and really get into these games once you warm up to the control scheme. And thus, the systematic destruction of Manchester United would begin.
Yes! Yes, it's there! Moriente! Oh, yes! And he's finishing off in style, and what a game he's having here! And the ball finding its way into the back of the net. Excellent control. The defence let him go, and it's in the back of the net. Seydorf. Oh dear, no luck for the keeper.
And Real Madrid would be champions of Europe because of my epicosity. The end.
And so, there you have it. There's so much in this game for you to try out that it's really hard to give you an estimated completion time since, well, there's so much you can do. And you will most likely need multiple sittings to get through everything if you, for example, you're playing a league or something. You know what? Even though football simulation games aren't really my forte, this one managed to give me a really good amount of fun sports action. I found myself really getting into it. So, in summary, how do I rate FIFA 99? Redundant question, actually. This game is actually really cool.
I'm very impressed with how much of the real deal the developers of this game were able to capture and show off in this game. For a 1998 release, it's a really good homage to the real-world football game. The models, graphics, and sound effects come together to make a rather immersive experience that is easy to lose yourself in. Everything isn't perfect about the presentation, with some minor texture issues, but it's hard to knock them because of when this game came out. Gameplay-wise, it is very solid, providing simple core mechanics for new players and novices to be able to play, and then going into very deep, sometimes overly deep detail with the advanced mechanics and tricks for seasoned football simulation professionals. It has truly catered for all skill types, and the pickup and playability of this game is pretty special. Outside of the gameplay, the menu navigation could have been fixed up a little. If it didn't have the awkward button navigation setup that it does have, I wouldn't have had as nearly as much trouble sifting through the menus and options. There'll also be some potentially annoying moments as you play the game, such as the seemingly random fouling and refereeing mechanics, but they're really few and far between. This game also has some fantastic multiplayer potential going for it, making it an ideal game for friends to have fun on.
I wouldn't say that FIFA 99 has done everything it possibly can to make the experience completely flawless, but for me it's still done one heck of a job. So my final rating for this game is 4 footballs out of 5, and this has deservedly made its way onto the treasure list. Now I leave it to you to let me know what you thought of this game in the comments below, and any positive or negative feedback you have about this video. Until next time, that'll do for today. All I can say now is stay you and stay awesome. You know what, playing this game has really got me hyped for the up and coming football season, so if you don't mind, come on, you bantams! Oh, hang on, wait a second. This is the away shirt, so this isn't claret and amber. Well,
Hey, thanks for watching, you lovely people. Be sure to give a like and a favourite if you like the video. And if you really liked it and you want more, consider subscribing to The Richaado Show so you can be among the first to see new content when it's ready. Thanks again, and I shall see you guys later on.